Hello learners, this is lecture 12 from unit 2. In this lecture we are going to see the problems on the HEB network, problems on the perceptron neural network and modeling architecture, flowchart and algorithm for modeling architecture. Now we start with the HEB neural network problem. This is a problem. We have two samples. First sample have the value of I, second sample have the value of O. We want to recognize the I value from the two sample. So target value for the first sample is plus 1, that is positive sample. Target value for the second one is minus 1, that is a negative sample. So wherever the data exists in the plus symbol, that locations are representing the value of 1. The empty square represents the value of minus 1. Here we are considering the bipolar input. So we have 1 and minus 1. If it is binary, we will have the value of 0 and 1. Now we consider the same thing in the tabular format. It will be like this. So inputs are from the 1 to 9 because it is 3 cross 3. Except the 4 and the 6th location, all other values are positive because 4 and 6th locations are empty. So I represent by using minus 1, minus 1. Target is plus 1. Consider this O. Except the 5th location, all are having the positive values and the target is minus 1. We have to update the weight. Change of weight, we have to calculate. For that, we have to initialize the weight with 0 value. All the weights are assigned with the 0 value and also the bias. So, we have a 9 input. Each input carries a separate weight. So, we have W1, W2 and so on up to W9. So, change of weight, multiplying this Xi value with the Y. So, we calculate the change of weight for all the 9 samples except the 4 and the 6, all are positive. Only for the W, delta W4 and W6, the value will be minus 1. So, the value will be like this. Now, we are going to update the weight. So, how to update the weight? Wi of new equal Wi of old plus X into Y. So, Xi into Y is represented by the delta Wi. So, W1 of new equal W1 of old plus delta W1. Delta W1 is 1. W1 of old we initialize with the 0 value. So, value will be 1 here. W2 is also 1. 3 is also 1. But the W4 we already have the value of 1. W4 old is 0. So, the value will be minus 1. So, W5 is 1. So, W6 already have the value of change of weight as the minus 1. 0 minus 1, the W6 value will be minus 1. W7 1, W8 1, W9 is also 1. So, based on this updated weight, now these weights are updated weight, we are going to continue for the second sample. So, consider the same example. Now, the weights are changed. Change just like this. So, I consider the change weight 1, 1, 1, minus 1, 1. Minus 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So, second sample, for the second sample, this is considered as the old weight. So, we are going to consider the second one. So, W1 of new equal W1 of old plus delta into X1. W1 of old is 1. The X1 value is 1. Multiplying with the target minus 1, the value will be 0. Consider the second one. Again, the 0 value. Consider the third one. So, multiplying the 1 into minus 1, the value will be 0. Consider the fourth one, plus 1 into minus 1, the minus 1. Weight is also minus 1, so the value will be minus 2. Take the fifth sample. Fifth sample, again 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 plus 1. We have the weight as the 1, so the value will be 2. W6 minus 2. W7 0, W8 0, W9 0. So, now we got the updated weight after handling this two sample. We can draw the neural network with updated weight. The bias is also minus 1 plus 1 into minus 1. The value will be 0. So, no need for a bias. This will be the output HEB network. So, bias is weight is 0. All the input X1 to X9 carries weight. The location X4 to X6 playing the vital role in recognizing the character I from the O. Wherever we doesn't need a data, so that location contains the value of minus 2. This area we need a data for a I, but that is not exist in the O. So the value will be plus 2. This is an exercise problem you can try. This is letter A. This is letter E. So handling this 2, 1, this one is plus 1, minus 1. You can solve this problem using the same head network. Now we take the problem under the perceptron neural network. The formula is slightly vary from the head network to the perceptron. Instead of wi of new equal wi of old plus xi into y, now we have the supervised neural network, what is called a perceptron. So wi of new equal wi of old plus xi into t. Here we are using the alpha. Alpha is also learning rate. So alpha tx. This is the two data. Now this is the I and this one is a f. So here the two locations are minus 1. This I again x4 and x is are minus 1. So now we want to recognize the data. So we first tablet everything into the tabular format. So x1 to x9, target 1 for the I character, target minus 1 for the F character. In the F, this two locations, this two location x8 and x9 are minus 1 because it is a bipolar data. Now we take the I sample. So before that we have to decide what are the activation function we are going to perform for this neural network. So theta is 0 here, alpha learning rate I fixed as 1. This is a ramp activation function. When the net input is greater than the 0, the output will be 1. If it is between the minus 0 to the 0, so the value will be minus theta to the theta, the value will be 0. If it is less than the minus theta, the value will be minus 1. Now we consider the theta as a 0. So it will look like a ramp. First we start with the first sample. We know that target value we are expecting is the 1. So first we have to calculate the net input. Y in equal bias plus summation of 1 to 9 xi into wi. So what is the x1 value? X1 value is 1 and w1 value is the 0 we initialize. We have to initialize actually. So all the weights are 0 and we have the weight, sorry, x1 value, x1, x2, we have the value of 1, 1, 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 1, 1, 1, so total net input value will be 0. Suppose I apply the activation function. So, y equal to f of y in, the target we got as the 0 because a 0, here we have the 0 as the output. So, we have to compare the calculator output with the target. Both are not equal, so then only we have to update the weight. If they are equal, no need to update the weight. So, now I apply the formula wi of new equal wi of old plus alpha into t x1. Old is 0, we initialize all the weights as 0. So 0 plus that alpha value we assumed as the 1, 1 into t, t is the 1 and x1 value, the value will be 1. For the w2, the value is 1, w3, the value is 1. Take the w4, now we have the minus 1, so the value will be minus 1. Take this x5, the value will be 1, w6 again minus 1, so w7, 1. W8 is also 1, W9 as usual 1. So now we got the updated weight. So we have to update the bias also. Bias old plus alpha into t, t is 1, alpha is 1, bias old is 0. So the bias new is the 1. This is the updated weight after handling the first sample. Now we have to consider the second sample, that is a F sample. For the sample we have to update the weight. Now this weights are become as the old weight for my current sample. So second sample x2 equal this value, t for the second sample is minus 1, calculate the net input, summation of xi into wi plus b. Now the w1 what we taken here, this x1 is the 1 and w1 value is 1, x2 is 1, w2 value is 1, so and so on. We will calculate the yin, yin is equal to 2. Then the output will be 1 because the greater than the threshold value 0. So it will produce the output as 1. Again that calculated output is not equal to the target. Target we are expecting for the second sample is minus 1. So we have to update the way WAF new equal WAF old plus alpha into TX1. Already we have that W new of old, W old. So the value will be 0 for W1. W2 the value will be 0, W3 0. So consider the value W4. 4 will become as the minus 2 because so we have a minus 1 for the W4 old is minus 1 plus the alpha value is 1 and the t is also minus 1, that x4 value is plus 1. So minus 1 the value will be minus 2. Consider the W5, the value will be 0. W6 again same as like W4, the value will be minus 2. W7 value will be 0. W8 the value will be 2. W9 again the value will be 2. So we got the updated weight bias equal. Bias old is 1. So 1 into minus 1 the bias will be 0. Now we have to draw this updated weight in the perceptron neural network. Updated weights are 0, 0, 0, minus 2, 0, minus 2, 0, 2, 2, 0. This is the updated perceptron neural network. To classify these two samples as I and F, we have to use this weight for the 9 input. This is an exercise problem. You can try it of your own. So, using the perceptron neural network, these are the 4 samples x1, x2, x3, x4, and we have a 2 positive sample with the targets of 1, 2 negative sample with the target of minus 1. We have to use the learning rate alpha as the 1, all the initial weights as well as bias as the 0. So, for input, we have to go for one epoch and understand that how the perceptron weights are varying for handling this sample list. So now we see that AMD implementation using the perceptron neural network for bipolar input. So AND is the 1 into 1, 1, 1 into minus 1. So 1 is a minus 1 is a 0. So 1, 0, 0, 0 minus 1, 0, 0, 0, the value will be 0. So initial weight for that perceptron neural network weights are W1, W2, 0 because only 2 input for AND gate, X1 and X2. So W1, W2 and output is Y. Bias is also 0. Theta value we assumed as the 0 now. So this is the activation function. So we use the ramp function again. If it is greater than the value will be 1. Equal to the value will be 0. Less than the value will be minus 1. So instead of the threshold value, here we use the threshold value as the 0. So first we have to calculate the net input. So, how to calculate the net input? We initialize all the weights as 0. So, y in for this sample, consider the first sample. So, 1 into 0, again 1 into 0, the value will be 0. Apply the activation function for the 0. Activation function will give the result of 0, but we are expecting the target as the 1. So, definitely we have to update the weight. So, how to update the weight? W of new equal W of old plus alpha into TX1. Old value is 0, alpha value is 1, target is also 1, X1 is 1, so the value will be 1. W2 of new, the value will be again 1, bias new, the value will be 1. So now we got the updated weight. For this one, we have to take the second sample. Consider the second sample. Before that, for our understanding, I copied all the values and result I got for that sample in the tabular format because I have to assume that how many epochs I have to continue this process. Epoch 1 is one training pair completely running for one time to that neural network. This is the first epoch. For this epoch, we have a 4 sample. First, we started with the 1, 1. So, we got the target, we assumed as the target 1, calculated output is 0. Because these two are not the same, so we updated the weight from the 0, it changed as a 1, 1, 1. Now, we have to consider the second input. Second input is 1, 1, target minus 1. Second input is 1, minus 1. So, the target is minus 1. Now, we have to calculate the net input. The net input formula is yin equal bias plus summation of x1 into xi into wi. Here we have a two input x1, x2. Weights for the x1 and x2 already we calculated for the first sample. So updated weights of 1 and w2 it's 1. So yin value will be bias 1 plus w1 into x1 plus w2 into x2. So bias plus x1 into w1 again 1 plus x2 minus 1 minus 1 into 1 will be minus 1. So the value will be 1. Apply the activation function for this yin ramp function. F of yin is also 1. But we know that the target value is minus 1. So calculated output is not equal to the target output. We have to update the weight. So update the weight. W new equal W old plus alpha into T x1. Now the old values are 1, 1, alpha 1, T is minus 1, x1 value is 1, x2 value is minus 1. So W1 of new equal 0, W2 of new equal W2 old is 1 plus alpha 1, T value is 1, x2 value is minus 1, the value will be 2. So we got the updated weight. Now we have to calculate for the bias. Bias new equal bias old plus alpha into t. Bias old value is 1. Alpha value is 1. T is the minus 1 value. So we got the value as 0. We have to tabulate all the values in the second row of that epoch 1. So if I take the 1 and minus 1, target will be minus 1. So I calculated the net input 1. Calculated output is 1. 1 is not equal to the minus 1, so we apply the weight change. So updated weights are 0 to 0. So change of weight, that is delta W1, only this portion alpha T is represented here. It shows that how much weights are changed from the previous weight to the current weight. Now we consider the third input. So x1 equal to minus 1, x2 equal to 1. Again the target value is minus 1. First we have to calculate the y in. Now the bias value is 0 plus w1 value is also 0 since 2 portion will become as 0. W2 is 2, x2 value is 1. So the y in value will be 2. So for this y in I apply the activation function. So the y in will become as f of y in will be 1. But our target minus 1, calculated output is not equal to the target output. We have to update the weight. So W2 1 of new equal, now the old weight is 0, alpha value is 1, target is minus 1, x1 value is minus 1. So the value will be 1. W2 of new equal W2 old 2 plus alpha value 1, T value is minus 1, x2 value is plus 1. So the value will be 1. Bias old is 0, alpha into T, 1 into minus 1. So the value will be minus 1. So we have to tabulate this third input to the third sample of the epoch 1. So we have the updated weight 1, 1, minus 1. We continue with the fourth input. That's the last input of this epoch. The x1 equal to minus 1, x2 equal to minus 1, target is 1. We calculate the net input, y in equal, bias plus summation of the xi into wi, bias is minus 1. So x1 value is minus 1 into plus 1, the value will be minus 1, so minus 2. X2 value is minus 1. Y2 value is, W2 value is 1, the value will be 1. So yin is 1. Suppose I apply the activation, yin will be minus 3. Suppose I apply the activation function for this one, the value will be minus 1, but the target is also minus 1. Sorry, this is minus 1 because the last input minus 1 minus 1 we expecting minus 1. So calculated output is equal to the target output. No need to update the weight. So this is a one epoch, complete epoch we run for this perceptron neural network. We have to stop our algorithm until all these areas are in the non-changeable mode. So every area is there is no updation in the entire epoch, that time we can stop the algorithm. Otherwise we have to continue the same sample, same training pair for one more epoch. Now we start the second epoch. So second, for the second epoch, for sample, this one will be the old weight, 1, 1, minus 1, that will be the recent weight. Consider the second epoch. From the second epoch, first input will be x1, 1, x2, 1, target again 1. So y in value is already we calculated, is it? But the weight is 1, 1 here. So the value will be 1. If it is 1, the target value is, we have to calculate, f of y in is also 1. Both are same, so no need to update the weight. We should not stop here, we have to try the second sample also, because there may be some updation in the second sample. So consider the second sample. Second sample, 1 minus 1, target is minus 1. So calculate the net input, y in equal. So there is no change in that weight. Consider the bias minus 1, w1 into x1. So the value will be 1, w2 into x2, the value will be minus 1. So the value will be minus 1, f of y in is also minus 1, target is also minus 1, both are same now, so no need to update the weight. We have to continue for the third input pattern. Consider third input pattern, minus 1, 1, target is minus 1. Y in value we calculated is minus 1. F of y in is also minus 1. Target is also minus 1. So no need to update the weight. So we should not stop here. We have to go for a last sample of this epoch also. Consider the fourth input pattern. Minus 1, minus 1. Target value is also minus 1. Calculate the net input. Net input value is minus 3, because there is no change from the last one to up to this case. So this is minus 3. Apply the activation minus 3. So f of y in will be minus 1. Target equal to minus 1. So there is no need to update the weight. So for this entire epoch, you can see there is no change in the weight. This portion is completely 0. And the weights are in the same mode, 1, 1, minus 1. So here we can start the algorithm. That way, if you want to run the algorithm for n epochs, when the point is reaches this correct value without any updation, this point is called as a convergence point. For AND gate, you have to use this 1, 1, minus 1 as the weight. Then only it will classify the given sample in a correct way. Now we move to the next topic of this today lecture, multiple adaptive linear neuron. This is the extension of the Adeline neural network. The model consists of many Adeline layers with a single output unit whose values are based on the certain selection rule. Here also we have that Adeline layer, that's a hidden layer. So from that Adeline layer to the Madeline layer, the weights are fixed positive and possess the equal value. But the learning only happens between the input layer to the Adeline layer. They are adjusted during the training process. So in the architecture we are going to see, we have a n units of input layer, m units of Adeline, and only one unit in the Madeline layer, that is the output layer. So each neuron in the Adeline and Madeline layer has the bias value of excitation of 1. So Adeline layer is present between the input and the Madeline layer, hence the Adeline layer is considered as a hidden layer. We will see the architecture now. We have a input layer x1, x2, x3 and so on, xm. These are the input pattern now. Each are having the weight. Weight connecting two different input to the hidden nodes. So we have the 1, 1, 1, j, 1, m, because there is m Adeline neurons in the hidden layer. Last Madeline layer, we have only one output. Here from the hidden layer to the Madeline layer, all are positive weight, v1 to vm. Here we have the x1 to z1, all the weights can be adjustable. V1 equal to v2 equal vm equal 1 by 2. Bias is, I assumed, as the 1 by 2. We apply the bipolar activation function. If the net input is greater than the threshold value, output will be 1. If it is less than the threshold value, the output will be minus 1. So our ultimate aim, we have to update this w weights based on that signal we got from the output unit. Now we try the algorithm for this one. So algorithm, we will start with the initialization of the weight and setting the learning rate that is alpha. When the stopping condition is false, we have to continue the process for each bipolar training pair, because it is a supervised learning, we have to continue the steps. First work, we have to get the S colon T. S is the input, T is the target. The S we have to assume to the local variable xi. Calculate the net input for each adeline unit. Now we have a m adeline unit from starting from the 1 to m. So up to that j is vary from the 1 to m xi into wij. We have to calculate the net input. Instead of the y symbol, now we have the hidden layer input. So I use the symbol comma z in j. J vary from the 1 to n. This is the net input. For this we have to apply the activation function. We will get the output z1, z2 and so on, zj, m. So this zm will be acting as the input to the Madeleine layer. Again we have to calculate the output as the output at the Madeleine layer. Here the weights are v1, v2 and so on up to vm. So each v carry the some positive value, that is equal value. There is no updation in that hidden layer to the Madeleine layer. And the input to the output neuron is what we got as the output from the hidden unit. So bias is applied here. We use the symbol yin, that is a total output for the entire neural network. Apply the activation function to that location. So if we got the target equal to the calculated output, no need for updation. Otherwise, we have to update the weight, bias new equal bias old plus alpha into t minus y in. Instead of the y in, now we have the z in j. I already told you y in is the output of the Madeleine. There is no updation in the y in layer. So we have to update only the z in j. Instead of that t, we specify there are only two output because we are applying for the bipolar output. If it is plus 1, we use the 1. If it is minus 1, we will directly use the minus 1. So same Hebb rule we updated, wijk of old plus alpha into minus 1 minus z in k. Otherwise positive output, positive target 1 minus z in j. So until my convergent point is reached, you have to continue the same step. Now we check the algorithm. So first we start with the flowchart. Initial weight, set up the value for the alpha. For each s colon t, we have to continue the task. X equal to z I, calculate the net input, calculate the output. That output will act as the input to the Madeleine unit. Calculate the entire output. Check for calculated output is equal to the target output. If it is equal, then no need to update the weight. Directly you can come out from this location to this one. Otherwise, we have to check whether it is positive. T is positive, you have to use this formula. T is negative, you have to come this location. So, if there is no need for weight updation, you have to check whether the number of epoch is reached. If it is okay, you can start the algorithm. Otherwise, you have to continue the steps and come back again to the this location. Okay. This is a summary of this entire lecture 12. So, we started with the neural network in this unit 2. We started with the MP neuron. All are fixed weight, maybe excitatory or incubatory. Hebb network, wi of new equal wi of old plus xi into y. So we take on the supervised learning with the training pair. Under that we have a three neurons. One is a perceptron neural network, Adeline and Madeleine. Formula differ from each one based on the Hebb neural network. Instead of xi into y, we have a alpha t into xi. So alpha minus alpha into t minus y in j, that is an error term into x. For your Adeline, instead of y in, we take on the z in j, that is a hidden layer, multiply with the x. Here the alpha talking about the learning rate, t talking about the target. X is the input, y in j is the net input for the Adeline layer, z in j is the net input of the hidden layer. We will discuss the remaining supervised learning in the forthcoming class. Thank you, students.